Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you how to disable deprecated SSL protocol versions. So let's get started. An SSL TLS version offered by the server is outdated. The deprecated versions contain weak implementations that cannot be considered secure anymore. Make sure that your web server offers only recent and strong protocol versions. An SSL TLS version offered by the server is outdated. The deprecated versions contain weak implementations that cannot be considered secure anymore. Make sure that your web server only offers recent and strong protocol versions. In their latest cheat sheet for transport layer security, the OWASP guide recommends the following setting. The SSL protocols have many weaknesses and should not be used in any circumstances. General purpose web applications should only support TLS 1.2 and TLS 1.3 with all other protocols disabled. SSL versions 2 and 3. Secure Socket Layer was the original protocol used to provide encryption for HTTP traffic in the form of HTTPS. There were two publicly released versions of SSL, versions 2 and 3. Unfortunately, both of these have severe cryptographic weaknesses and should no longer be used. TLS version 1.0 to 1.3, SSL version 3.1 to 3.4. For various reasons, the next version of the protocol, effectively SSL 3.1, was named Transport Layer Security version 1.0. Subsequently, TLS versions 1.1, 1.2, and 1.3 have been released. Terminology. The terms SSL, SSL TLS, and TLS are frequently used interchangeably, and in many cases, SSL is used when referring to the more modern TLS protocol. To disable the deprecated SSL TLS protocol versions, please refer to Secure TLS configuration. Why are security protocols important? You should care about TLS because it protects data in transit from eavesdropping, tampering, or message modification. If a hacker wants to steal information from you, they will have to intercept the traffic between your computer and the website you're trying to access. They won't be able to get any of the data on its own because it's encrypted, but they can attempt to impersonate the site owner and trick you into giving them sensitive information. To disable the deprecated SSL TLS protocol versions, please refer to the Secure TLS configuration video. To protect data in transit, TLS uses asymmetric cryptography. In this scenario, two keys are used, one is public, and the other is private. When you send a request to a website, you use the public key to encrypt the connection so that only the intended recipient can decrypt it. If someone else tries to intercept the communication, they'll see gibberish instead of the original content. When using HTTPS, the browser first connects with the server over an unencrypted HTTP session. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.